Hello everyone, in this video I will discuss about the types of alternative dispute resolution. As in my previous video, I have discussed about the meaning and concept of alternative dispute resolution. So in this video, let's check out the types of ADR. Based on the nature and modus operandi, please focus on the two terms, that is nature and modus operandi. Okay, alternative dispute resolution can be categorized as arbitration, administrative tribunals, mediation, conciliation, Lok Adalat, Ombudsman, Lokpal, and Lokayukta. Okay, so these seven are the major types of ADR or alternative dispute resolution in India. Now, let's discuss each one of them separately. So in this video, I will discuss only about the arbitration, and in my next video, administrative tribunals, and so on and so forth. So let's first understand the meaning of arbitration. What does it mean? Arbitration is the method or procedure of civil dispute resolution outside the court. How simple it is, because here you need to focus on two terms. Arbitration is the method of civil dispute resolution. So you need to focus on civil. It is not allowed or permitted for the criminal dispute. Okay, it is only applicable in case of civil dispute. And the second term you need to focus on outside the court. Okay, so this procedure cannot be conducted inside the court or court premises. Now, the major features of arbitration are: it is a private arrangement, so there is no contact with the public at all. It is less adversarial, okay, as you do not need to follow the strict and lengthy and complex litigation or adversarial process, okay. It is less formal, though it is formal, but in comparison to litigation, it is less. It is more flexible forum. So, flexibility means what? Now you have the choices in terms of choosing your arbitrator, in terms of choosing the date of hearing, in terms of choosing the time of hearing, in terms of choosing the place of hearing. Okay, so based on all these aspects, we can say that it is flexible, as you can fix the things as per your convenience. Okay, it is less expensive. And lastly, it is less time taking or a speedy mode of dispute resolution. So your dispute can be resolved in matter of a few days. But in litigation, you know that it will take more than 2 years, 3 years. You don't know how much time it will take. Likewise, arbitration is a procedure in which a dispute which is consensually, again focus on the term, consensually submitted by disputants to one or more arbitrators to get it resolved in an amicably manner. So you need to focus on where, that is consensually, because if both the parties agreed to resolve their dispute through arbitration, only then it is possible. If one party is ready and another one is not, then it is not possible. Now let's check out the characteristics of arbitration. The principal characteristics of arbitration are: it is consensual. We have discussed already a few minutes ago. Means arbitration is possible only when both the parties are willingly agreed to resolve their dispute through arbitration, otherwise not. Okay. Secondly, it gives freedom to parties to choose arbitrator. Under such dispute resolution method, parties have the freedom to choose the arbitrator. Either both the parties together will choose one arbitrator, or both the parties will choose two arbitrators, one each separately. And then these two chosen arbitrators will choose the third arbitrator, who is known as neutral arbitrator. Thirdly, it is neutral. In addition to having the freedom of choosing the arbitrators, parties have also freedom to choose applicable law, language and venue of the arbitration. Such neutral feature ensures that no party enjoys a home court or law advantage. So, if you are dealing with any sort of business with any person, you can insert in your agreement the arbitration clause, where you can mention that if any dispute arises in future, then that will be resolved through arbitration. And not only this, you also put certain clauses that defines what are the laws that being applied in order to resolve this dispute. Okay, and what will be the language of such procedure, and what will be the place, venue of the arbitration. So everything you need to define in such agreement. Okay, so all such features collectively define it as a neutral. Okay, next one is arbitration is a confidential procedure. Such procedure is conducted privately at private place. So there is no scope of disclosure. On the other hand, under such dispute resolution procedure, maintaining the confidentiality of each other is essentially required. Okay, so no party is supposed to be disclosing such matters publicly. That is against the ethics. Okay, last but not the least, the award of arbitrators is final and easy to enforce. What does it mean? That under such procedure, the parties normally agree to carry out the decision of the arbitrators without delay, because it is consensual and it is already agreed upon that if any dispute arises in future, they will get it resolved through arbitration. So whatever the award given by an arbitrator, they happily accept in normal circumstance. Normally, I'm emphasizing on this term, because there is chance they may refuse, or one party may refuse if not satisfied. Further, international arbitration awards are enforced by national courts. See, if it is an international arbitration awards, then it can be enforced by national courts under the New York Convention. Okay, so our next topic is types of arbitration. Following are the major types of arbitration, which is based on the subject matter and the nature of modus operandi. Again, domestic arbitration, the arbitration procedure that takes place on Indian land, in which parties are Indians and the dispute is decided in accordance with the Indian law, namely Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. That is known as domestic arbitration. So simple. Next one, international or foreign arbitration. When the arbitration procedure either takes place on Indian territory or foreign territory. So keep in mind, it doesn't matter. What does not matter? That is venue, the place. It may be in India or it may be outside India. But wherein some of the ingredients are foreign in nature, such as one party may be a foreigner, or the subject matter of the dispute, or the law applied to resolve the dispute are international law, is known as international arbitration. So any of such feature, if doesn't belong to India, like one party may be from outside India, I mean if he is foreigner, or if the procedure or the place that is on foreign land, or if the laws applied to resolve the dispute that is not the Indian law, rather an international law. So any of such feature is there, then we can say that it is international or foreign arbitration. Next one is ad hoc arbitration. What does it mean? That its meaning is integrated in its name only. So just pay attention and you understand the meaning. See, when both the parties themselves decide to conduct the arbitration process without consulting with any arbitration institution, is known as ad hoc arbitration. It could be either domestic or international. So what does it mean? That when two parties, see, for example, you have dispute with your friend, and instead of going to any institution, that is the firm, the organization that set up to provide only arbitration service. So instead of contacting any such arbitration center, you yourself, with the consent of your friend, have chosen a third party as an arbitrator and get decided your matter, get resolved your matter. So that is known as ad hoc arbitration. The next one is institutional arbitration. So on the contrary, in relation to ad hoc arbitration, if you have the dispute with your friend, instead of yourself deciding or choosing the arbitrator, what you do, you consult an institutional arbitration center, okay, and ask them to resolve your dispute, okay. So that is known as institutional arbitration. So example of such arbitration centers are the London Chamber of International Arbitration, LCIA, which head office is located in London, but it has the regional offices across the world. Another one is American Arbitration Association, AAA, which is located in New York. Some of such institutional arbitration centers in India are the Indian Council of Arbitration, ICA, located in New Delhi, Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry, FICCI, located in, again, in New Delhi, International Center for Alternative Dispute Resolution, ICADR, again it is located in New Delhi. Besides, there is World Intellectual Property Organization, in short WIPO, W-I-P-O, an agency of the United Nations. Pay attention, WIPO is an agency of the United Nations which provides services for intellectual property disputes. Next one is a statutory arbitration. It means an arbitration which is mandatorily imposed on the parties by operation of a particular law or a statute applicable to them. So in a condition when arbitration is imposed upon the parties because of any legal provision or agreement, then it is known as a statutory arbitration. For example, the Defense of India Act 1971 is one of such legislation that mandates a recourse to arbitration in case of any dispute arising within the act. Okay, so in that condition, parties have no choice other than to resolve their dispute through arbitration. Fast track arbitration. What does it mean that? Fast track arbitration, which is also known as documents only arbitration, is time bound arbitration. Okay, it is another beautiful concept. It has comparatively stricter rules of a procedure. See, it has comparatively stricter rules of a procedure which do not allow for any laxity. So there is no scope of delay or a scope for extensions of time and delays. Okay, so whatever the procedure is defined under this, that will be followed on time. Not only followed, but followed on time. Okay, so fast track arbitrations are best suited in those cases. See, it is not applicable in all the cases, but rather only in those cases which can be resolved on the foundation of documents, and that oral hearings and witnesses are not essentially required. So the kind of dispute which can be resolved based on only the documents, and there is as such no hearings and witnesses are required, then it can be easily resolved through fast track arbitration. Lastly, we have international commercial arbitration, which is defined under the section 21F of the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. It is a procedure of an arbitration in which one party or disputant is foreigner. Okay, the dispute regarding the parties, one party is Indian and one party is foreigner, and they are doing some business, and if having the dispute, then if they resolve through the arbitration, that is known as international commercial arbitration. Laws on arbitration. The next topic we have, that is laws on arbitration. The law that governs the arbitration is defined under the Arbitration and Conciliation Act 1996. The Act provides an elaborate codified rule of the concept of arbitration. What does it mean that the provisions of arbitration, the rules of the arbitration are codified and well explained under the name of Arbitration and Conciliation Act. While drafting this act, international conventions are being considered. For example, the United Nations Commission on International Trade Law, that is UNCITRAL, Model Law on International Commercial Arbitration, 1985. So, the Arbitration and Conciliation Act of 1996 is, you can say that, more or less being inspired by such international conventions. Okay, now the next point that we have to discuss, that is the process of arbitration. It is very important. Okay, so pay attention. In a normal circumstance, the procedure of arbitration is chosen by parties either through their prior agreement. See, if you have any business agreement with anyone, and in that agreement, if you mention the clause that if any dispute will arise in future, then that will be resolved through arbitration. So that is prior agreement. So if you have the prior agreement, then of course you are bound to get resolve your dispute through arbitration. That is known as through prior agreement. Or the second category, that is the reference of the court. So in certain circumstance, it is court that refers to resolve your dispute through arbitration, then you have to go for the arbitration. However, in whatever way it is chosen, irrespective of that, it has following procedures to resolve a dispute. What does it mean that? So whether it is based on the prior agreement or court referred to go for the arbitration, in both the circumstances, the procedure of arbitration will be same. So let's check out the procedure. The procedure normally can be categorized into four steps. The first step is known as arbitrator appointment stage. What parties do in this stage? First, both the parties together choose an arbitrator, or in certain other circumstances, both the parties choose two arbitrators, okay, one each party separately, and after that these two chosen arbitrators choose the third arbitrator, neutral arbitrator. So first step is appointment of arbitrator. The second stage is preliminary hearing and information exchange stage. So what happens that once you have chosen the arbitrator, then there will be a formal meeting. Okay, the preliminary hearing takes place under which the issues are addressed and exchange of information takes place. So what happens that once you have chosen the arbitrator, and general meeting will be held under which the issues are addressed, what are the issues, and information will be exchanged between the parties and with the arbitrator. So what happens that arbitrators or arbitrator come to know about the issues and all those things, try to understand this matter and cause of action, etc. After such exchange of information, arbitrator consensually schedule the order which gives all the important dates of hearing. So what is happening here? Once arbitrator understood the facts, okay, and issues, what he or they, whatever the condition is, they do, they schedule the dates of hearings, okay, because it takes certain number of hearings. It's not something like that in one hearing the case will be decided, okay. So here, arbitrators normally fix the dates of hearings. So, third stage is hearing stage. Now, hearing starts. During this stage, both the parties present their matters to the arbitrators along with the required documents and other facts and evidence. So during the hearing, both the parties are required to present the required documents, facts and evidence in order to support their matters, their claim. Okay? Based on the given facts and evidence, the case is heard and discussed in detail. Okay? Now, the fourth stage is the award stage, and it is our last stage. Once it is ensured that no more facts and evidence will be presented by either of the parties, so whatever they have, they presented. The hearing is closed and a date of issuance of award is set. So it's not like that award is being given then and there, no. After the completion of hearing, the date is fixed, okay, and then the arbitrators render a written award. Focus on written award, it's not verbal, it's a written award under which outcome the case is explained in detail and then delivered to the respective parties. Okay, so likewise there are four steps of process of arbitration. The first one is arbitrator appointment stage, second one is preliminary hearing and information exchange stage, third one is hearing stage, fourth one is award stage. Now we have two more subtopics of arbitration, that is the advantages of arbitration. Since we have such a wonderful kind of dispute resolution method, so there are number of advantages. More or less we have discussed while discussing the feature and characteristics. Nevertheless, just check it out. It is less formal, but it has greater chance of the enforcement of award. Okay, so its award is binding upon the parties in the sense that they are agreed for the dispute resolution through arbitration. So it is consensual, so they have to accept the award. Secondly, its procedure is faster and flexible, you know that, which gives freedom to both the parties to choose arbitrators of their choice. In addition to this, parties as per their convenience can also choose the date, time and place of hearing. Okay. Next one is it maintains the confidentiality of dispute and disputants both. Okay. And lastly, it protects parties from the lengthy and expensive legal proceedings. So these are the important advantages of arbitration. Now, it is not like that it hasn't any disadvantage. Of course, it has a few disadvantages. Okay, so let's check it out. Following are the major disadvantages of arbitration. In arbitration, there is chance of biasness of an arbitrator, which may negatively affect one party. Okay, so in such a beautiful method of dispute resolution, arbitrator may get carried away and may get biased. There is possibility. The second one is, in case of weak or small cases, claims, arbitrators may be reluctant to dispose of on summary basis. So this is another disadvantage where arbitrators may not take interest in the case of petty matters or small claims. Last but not the least, there is limited grounds for challenges and appeals, which together with the confidential nature of the process can create a risk of a lack of intellectual rigor in the award. Okay, so as we have seen that, since it is consensual and with agreement, so there is less chance to refuse the award given by arbitrator. So parties are bound to accept that largely or in normal circumstances. So that is the disadvantage, as party cannot appeal, whereas in case of litigation, parties have always opportunities to appeal in higher court. Okay, so this is all about the arbitration. Likewise, just take a recap what we have discussed in this video, because this is comparatively a longer video. So we will take a recap. I started with the types of ADR, where I have mentioned the 7 types of ADR, that is arbitration, administrative tribunals, mediation, conciliation, Lok Adalat, Ombudsman, Lokpal and Lokayukta. And then I started with the arbitration, where I have mentioned about the features of arbitration, characteristics of arbitration, types of arbitration, laws on arbitration, process of arbitration, where I have mentioned the 4 steps, okay, and lastly advantages and disadvantages of arbitration. So this is all for this video. See you in next video, where I will be discussing about the administrative tribunals. So keep watching.